to know you the next day or two. So this is an important time in Lexus's history. A lot of you probably realize that we're just passing our 26-year anniversary. And of course, you know that in the U.S. we've got the longest history with Lexus compared to any of the other global markets where we're now active. But the RX specifically launched in 1998 as a 1999 model, and it really quickly became a pillar of the brand's success. And not only for what it did from a sales perspective, but for what it did to the industry. Really, it developed an entirely new segment that has gone on quite successfully. So in 99, that RX really was an instant success. We think it was that because it met an unmet need at the time. Really, it was a simple, winning formula that really helped the RX grow this new segment, and that was to use a unified platform. So by offering car-like handling, car-like MPG, and a very refined driving experience, it was a nice change versus the truck-based products that were in the market at that time. So I think if you look back, we really helped to shift the luxury SUV paradigm, what it could be, what it should be. And we also did a really good job, I think, finding opportunity for a new brand, a young brand in the market. And part of that opportunity in terms of volume really comes from the fact that we've got an almost fanatical fan base in the US. These are highly loyal customers who love their RXs. They make a repeat purchase, a very frequent occurrence both in their lives and in ours. And in fact, RX is a fixture basically in luxury sales. It's one of only two vehicles in the luxury market here in the US that regularly sells roughly 100,000 units a year, and the other one, of course, being the BMW 3 Series. So we're pretty good at that company. If you think back to when the RX launched, the brand was still very young. The brand was less than 10 years old. So RX provided a pretty vital boost to kind of the dealer attitude, dealer outlook. You know, in 89, we launched Lexus. We introduced a number of models. They quickly matured in the marketplace. So when RX came along, the timing was ideal to really reignite momentum and really drive sales to kind of a next level. And on top of that, it helped us validate an internally held belief, and that was really very simple, that Lexus could, in fact, lead the sales race in luxury, and of course, we went on to do that for a number of years. Now, when the RX came to be, and that market started to form around the RX, more unibody players, there were about five entries early days. We had a 30% share of that market. If you fast forward to 2015, there's roughly 16 players in the market now, and we have a 15% share. So we maintain a really strong share in a market that's gotten increasingly crowded. We've really proven, I think, longevity with the RX. Now, if we look at the overall luxury landscape, I think you would agree that you see a lot of brands moving toward a much more aggressive, emotional design language. And I think you have to agree, if you look at the sales of the past few years, the market is generally nodding its approval. So too, with Lexus, since 2012, we've essentially evolved every product in our lineup. We have fresh products that we think help us not only maintain loyalty, but also target the next generation of luxury buyers. So I think it's safe to say, and you've heard us say it directly, Lexus is simply not happy only being a rational brand that is known for bringing reliability. Lexus is working very hard. It's quite apparent the last several years that we want to add a level of emotion to the brand that was lacking before. I think there's several proof points of that. Easy ones to look at are models like the IS, the all-new MX we introduced this year, that have quickly gained a lot of favor in the market. Now, with the RX, we do think we've got a vehicle that's been completely reimagined, right? It reflects a much more driver-oriented nature of the car, and I think there's a lot of rub off to the overall brand as a result of that. There's a number of broad improvements that I think will be reflected in loyalty, but also do speak to another group of shoppers coming to market. The expressive design, we like to think of it as almost a sophistication with an edge. The floating roof line adds a sense of modernity to that. And even in the most basic RX, I think what you'll find when you see the vehicle in the flesh tomorrow is that there's almost the essence of S4, even the most basic vehicle, has a much more aggressive stance than you would have expected in the past generation. Now let's talk about how we're going to bring it to market, the flavors of RX, if you will. So, start with the RX 350, the 3.5 liter V6. more powerful, updated from the last generation, with a standard 8-speed automatic. To that, you can add the S-Sport trim level, which of course gives you chassis tuning and overall sharpened driving experience. And then, of course, if you look to add the S-Sport with the chassis experience. On the inside, of course, if you look at the completely reimagined, completely restyled interior, you're going to be really impressed with that. One of the key features is the 12.3-inch screen that's in the center of the IP. On top of that, of course, we have Lexus Safety System Plus. You'll hear about that quite a bit the next day. It's a suite of safety and technology features. More important than that is the fact that we've now bundled them at a very high-value price opportunity, giving formerly very expensive features, making them available broadly. So as I mentioned, we've got the RX 350 with the 3.5-liter V6. We've got the F-Sport trim. Of course, we continue with the 458 hybrid entry. And then for the first time ever, we will combine the RX 450H with the availability of F-Sport. So you've got the best of both worlds coming together in one. Now, in terms of how we're going to bring the RX to market, I'm going to show you a rough cut, a 30-second broadcast spot, or it will be a broadcast spot, which was shot a couple of weeks ago. But I hope what you'll see for it, even in rough form, is that it gives the promise of the traditional luxury that people expect from the RX. But it layers on top of that modern elements that really reflect the newness and the boldness of the 2016 version. So have a look at this.
Those who define sophistication stand up. Those who dare to redefine it stand apart. Introducing the entirely new Lexus RX. Plus your RX, there's no going back.
So I think you can see in that spot, for years RX has kind of been hung with the label being for soccer moms, and I think now it's also for soccer dads. So it's a little bit of something for everybody in the RX. So with four spots that do launch the car in the United States. Now, in terms of how we think the RX will fare, we always do a lot of market testing for our new products. RX is no exception. And in this case, it did provide us with a lot of insight that we think helps to gauge how we do in the marketplace. So the results, I think, are both convincing and compelling. I'm going to give you three highlights from that research. Number one, we do think our loyalists are going to stay loyal. So I know there's people out there in the audience who are thinking they made a lot of change for this vehicle. Is that too much for the loyal buyer? The answer is no. The loyalists have confirmed that they're going to stick with RX. Number two is maybe even more interesting. Bigger conquest audience for RX than we've seen in the past, coming out of some German competitor owners that we had in our research, but primarily interested in the F-Sport, so the more aggressive play of RX, generated more interest with conquest. And then finally, a little more interest than we are accustomed to seeing RX with men. So we think there's an opportunity there. So overall, if you look at the loyalty, the conquest, greater male appeal, we do think that we have a good opportunity in the market with RX. RX was the number one choice, ranked first in all of the consumer testing we did in the US. Now the vehicles are gonna drive tomorrow, and all the RXs from North America then are being produced in Canada at our award-winning plant up in Cambridge, Ontario. And we're very excited to see the RX means for us in terms of ushering in that next chapter of Lexus in the US market. I'd like to give you a specific price point for the car. I don't have one, but I'll give you two clues that I think give you a pretty good sense of where we're headed. Number one, of course, the RX has always maintained a very high value position in the market. It will continue to be the value play. Number two, we expect that value play to be very much under $45,000 when it hits the market. And dealerships will have vehicles late in the month of November. Okay. So with all that as background, let me move this along and bring up Doug Herbert. A lot of you know Doug. Doug is from our Lexus College, and he's going to give you a technical overview of the vehicle. And then after that, we'll be going to